Well, how it came around originally is the current commissioner. Prior to him being commissioner back in 2015, I was teaching on the senior leadership programme at the College of Policing at Brams Hill. And that is where I met Richard for the first time. He attended one of the programmes I was running, and he saw the impact it had when he came back to Royal Gibraltar Police with a development plan to transfer the learning he'd got from the course back into policing.
Well, leadership is very important to the Royal Gibraltar Police, and what we're trying to do is create a culture of a leadership throughout the rank structure of the organisation. And so when I met Rob Priddy first in the College of Policing Senior Leadership Programme, he was a tutor and he had excellent motivational skills and was passionate about leadership. And I thought, who better to come to the Royal Gibraltar Police and deliver a course to our people who were going through a management programme to provide excellence in policing.
All the sergeants and inspectors, our middle management, have been attending the course. What we've taken away is trying to get leadership through excellence in leadership through being able to empower and motivate our team members.
And how do you think this will affect your policing going forward?
Well, I think some of the techniques we've been taught here are going to be put to use in terms of making a more positive environment for the officers to work in. And the knock-on effect of that will they will be out on the streets, more empowered, more consideration of their well-being, and therefore the theory is, and we're going to put into practice, more practical and more positive in their approach with the public and a better service at the end of that. So we're hoping it's going to increase public confidence at the end of the training as well.
We've put 47 inspectors and sergeants have been through the course, and I must say it has been an absolute honour to come over here, meet these individuals who want to do the best they can for their staff and their communities. So what we expect to see is they will leave the programme, although they've done 5 days, they leave with a development plan. And what that development plan is, how they are going to transfer what they have been able to learn during this week about themselves as leaders, and some of the skills, some of the models, some of the things they can use to provide a better service to their staff. We will evaluate what they've achieved in March after their 90-day period, and from that we should be able to demonstrate both to the Commissioner and to the people of Gibraltar how it has improved the service that their teams and themselves deliver.